welcome to Why Sport. It's Friday the 17th of February. I'm Andy Jackson.
And I'm Stephen Wright.
Coming up on the show, we preview the Olympics and talk with one of the greatest Paralympians ever.
Ash returns for another Ash Does. It's not to be missed.
And we will have our usual sporting previews. But first, it was announced on Wednesday, Scottish football club Rangers would enter administration. The Scottish champions are the most high-profile club to enter administration since Leeds United in 2007. However, could this happen to your club? Calum Hider has more.
It's hard to imagine your club no longer existing, but not every club have the means to spend without worry like Chelsea or Man City. Now, over recent seasons, we've seen more and more teams struggling to pay their debts. Darlington and most recently Glasgow Rangers have both entered administration. But what actually is administration? Now, football clubs enter administration when they are unable to pay outstanding debts. Once clubs enter administration, an administrator is appointed to the club and takes over the day-to-day running, as well as trying to find a suitable owner to take over the club. Now, in the meantime, all clubs which enter administration get automatically deducted 10 points. They also usually enter a transfer embargo, meaning they can't purchase any new players. But they are able to sell players and hopefully pay off some of the debts. Now, here in the North East, we've had a couple of clubs enter administration. As mentioned earlier, Darlow, and in the 1980s, Middlesbrough. They were saved by a local businessman, Steve Gibson, who is still the chairman. At the time of writing this, Darlington Football Club has many differing supporters groups who are trying to raise over £500,000 in order to convince administrators that a community buyout is a viable option. Now, the club has until April the 30th before it could be wound up. It's fair to say that Glasgow Rangers, on the other hand, are the biggest name to enter into administration. The fact that they fill their 40,000 seats on match days and the fact they have a world record amount of league titles and cups to their names, it means nothing when overspending and overreaching in order to regress and compete on the field. It's left them crippled. Now, FIFA financial fair play will be coming into play in the coming seasons, but the gulf between monies paid to Premier League clubs in TV rights and so on, compared to the money paid to lower league clubs, and in the case of the SPL, lesser league clubs, is something that needs further looking into. Back to you guys in the studio.
As Calum said, there are more positive news from fans group Darlington FC 1883 Limited. They've said that the club has raised enough money to operate till the end of the season. The fans group now need to raise a further £750,000 by April 30th.
If you want to get in contact with us on this or on anything else we discuss, tweet us at iSports, like us on Facebook or go to iSports.com. Now, the Olympic Games begin in just 161 days and the Paralympic Games are 194 days away. With this in mind, here at iSports, we've decided to profile some potential star names here in the region that could be heading to the Games. Steve has more.
Well, this week we're profiling one of the North East's most prolific athletes, Stephen Miller. Stephen is a three-time Paralympic gold medalist specialising in the club throw. He currently holds the world record in the event with a distance of 33.53 metres, which he set in the 2004 Games. He was due to be performing in two events at the Games, the discus and the club throw, but due to a hip injury, he's decided to concentrate solely on the club. Just how has he rated his chances of getting yet another gold? We sent our sports reporter Micky Welch to find out.
When the Olympics and Paralympics got announced as being running like 7 years ago, it was unbelievable at the time. No, and now it's only 6 months away. It's pretty hard to believe, but it is very exciting. Media storm's burning up already, and everybody's so enthusiastic about it and wants to see the GB athletes do well. So, from an athlete perspective, it's hard because I have to focus on doing the training and getting the work done and not get too excited about it.
Yeah, it's not going to be quiet when you bring back your fourth goals, and I'm guaranteeing that. I suppose there's going to be a massive party, and you're a massive Newcastle fan, so what about if Newcastle get fourth place and you get your fourth goal this summer?
Yeah, that would be really nice. That would just be a nice year off that, but I think there's more chance of me getting the goal than Newcastle placing fourth.
Now it is time for your sporting news from the week. Arsenal were humiliated by Milan in the first leg of their Champions League tie in the San Siro. The Gunners lost 4-0, meaning they have to score 5 without reply in the second leg to qualify for the quarterfinals.
Meanwhile, in the Europa League, there were wins for both Manchester sides. Manchester United beat Ajax 2-0, while City put Porto to the sword after coming from behind to win 2-1.
Alistair Cook inspired England to victory in the second one-day international against Pakistan in Dubai. The England captain secured 102 and England now hold an unassailable 2-0 lead in the series.
Former Newcastle defender Robbie Elliott revealed plans to cycle 3,500 miles in memory of former mentor Sir Bobby Robson. Elliott will cycle to the 8 clubs Sir Bobby managed in around 25 days, starting in Lisbon, ending in Newcastle.
The Formula One Bahrain Grand Prix will go ahead despite the return of violence in the country, according to F1 boss Bernie Eccleston. Violence erupted in the country 1 year on from the Day of Rage that took place on February the 14th last year.
France and Ireland will play their Six Nations match on Sunday, the March 4th. The game, originally scheduled for last Saturday, was called off due to a frozen pitch.
Now it is time for Ash Does, a feature where our very own Ash Bevan takes on a sport and tries to master it in just one session. This week it is weightlifting. The question is, will Ash become the next Muscles from Brussels?
Welcome along to iSports and for another special edition of Ash Does. Now you've seen me trampolining beautifully and cheerleading gracefully. Yes, everyone's agreeing. Now it's time for weightlifting.
Yes.
Now I'm here at Elswick Pool Centre in Newcastle with the Olympic Junior Weightlifting Team. Oh my God, can't believe I'm going about to go do this. Goodbye. My little bit of weightlifting. I've done what I thought was a lot of weightlifting, but to them it's a warm-up. I didn't have any weights, so I was just lifting up a pole. Not very well, if you'll see by the footage. I'm not very good. But the kids in there are amazing. One kid is lifting 50k. It's very impressive. But knackered, my arms hurt and my legs hurt, so it's a sign of weakness. But we'll be talking to Vika, who is the teacher.
How long have you been doing this?
Set it up in 2010 in May.
Yeah?
And we've started only with two people, then it was three people, and now it's fucked.
Like, what age groups do you go for?
Anyone from nine years of age, 9 to 94.
Really?
If there's anyone 113 wants to start lifting, this surely could have come to us.
Well, I just came in. Is that what a beginner would do?
Yeah.
Just with the pole, and then you just build
with
them
the bar,
up?
And you build up until you don't have any weight on. Like, unlike in maybe gymnastics, you'd have to have... You'd support your body weight. It's like handstands you'd be learning. You wouldn't anywhere near carry your own body weight on the bar until you learn technique, and then you build years and years of building up.
Do you need Olympic hopefuls?
I won.
You won?
I won.
Do you think
I very
if
much
you keep,
won.
You know,
I am going
time?
With. Yeah, I'll keep pulling mountains and plucking trees and shifting things. I'll be getting there, yeah. Not these ones, but possibly the ones after, because people who are coming in, they're really determined. It's quite admirable for someone who's 11. Mm. So that little person is 11, and she's so mentally strong. You know, I think...
She's really good.
I know.
Scary how
I know, it's
she
amazing.
They're all really good.
I would
good.
Have loved to have been in her shoes, to have a place where I could do weightlifting. It might, you know,
yeah.
At 11, I would have just been icing on the cake, but...
London Olympics, how important is it to have the Olympics in England, and how... Are you excited in the Northeast about the Olympics?
Very excited. I'm going to be there. I'm going to be there in the training hall because I'm volunteering with 2012. So, and that's going to be, from coaching point of view, to go and pick out anything that I can pick out and, you know, learn. And that's going to be another thing. And also, the weightlifting prepare series, where the test event was recently held in London at Excel. I had a couple of guys from here. The hopefuls, my juniors, they came and saw, so that was kind of an incentive.
Yeah.
And they came out to say, we want to be those guys. So that's brilliant. So that's, we just keep plugging.
Thanks, Ash. Now it is time for your sporting previews. Sunderland face Arsenal at the Stadium Light in the FA Cup fifth round. The Black Hats beat Middlesbrough in the last round, but lost to Arsenal in the Premier League last weekend. Steve, how do you rate Sunderland's chances?
Well, obviously, I wish it was Middlesbrough that were going to be playing this weekend. But Sunderland have definitely got a great chance. Manchester United, Manchester City already out. They've not really got much else to play for all season. I'm pretty sure they're going to be clear of relegation. Maybe not quite enough to get up to Europe. So the FA Cup could be definitely the pinnacle of their season.
It really could. Thanks, Steve. Newcastle have the weekend off as they are already out of the FA Cup, but there are other games around the region. In League One, Hartlepool will be looking to overcome disappointment of losing to Preston by beating Notts County this weekend.
In non-league action, Gateshead play away to Forest Green. The Heat earlier in the week progressed through the fourth round of the FA Trophy, where they will play Luton. Meanwhile, Darlington will look to move clear of the relegation places as they face Alfreton Town. Darlington have only won one of their last 10 league games.
On Tuesday, Middlesbrough travelled to Millwall in the Championship. Borough beat Nottingham Forest last Tuesday, recording their first win since Boxing Day, and will look back to getting the playoff places this week.
In other sports, the Newcastle Eagles will face the Durham Wildcats in a BBL Championship match tonight. The Eagles will look to keep up their good form and maintain their lead at the top of the table. We'll be there.
Indeed we will. That is it for this week. Thanks for watching. We'll be back at the same time next week. And remember, our radio show is this Monday between 12 and 2 on 107 Spark FM. Plus, you can keep up to date on iSports.com, on Twitter and on Facebook. There is some exclusive content behind the scenes of our radio show. We'll see you again next week. Take care. Goodbye.